Alright, welcome back to the channel. My name is Lian Duan, and I'm a content creator based here in Maryland. My goal with the channel is to be a resource to DevOps creative thought, tutorials behind the screen content, and honors podcasts. So, if you are into that sort of thing, make sure you subscribe to join the creative crew. It goes a long way towards supporting this channel, and it makes sure that you never miss out.Our video ready to markdown and access YAML files on my GitLab, the links are below. I start videos of GitLab CI/CD crash course. The crash course goal is run CI/CD pipeline to build my React UI microservice Docker image and the Spring Boot microservice Docker image. Finally, deploy the Docker images to the multiple cloud environment. Today, we'll talk aboutWhat are differences between the caches and artifacts in GitLab pipeline? If you watch the videos, use cache to speed up job execution in GitLab and how to use artifacts in GitLab pipeline, you will have more background of today's topics. After you finish the video, you are able to use caches and artifacts in right away in your project. Video topic is, how do I use caches and artifacts in React UI project pipeline. What are differences between caches and artifacts in GitLab pipeline? How to use caches and artifacts perfectly? First topic is how to use caches and artifacts in React UI project pipeline. You see the React UI pipeline chart. We talk about artifacts first. The UI build job creates an artifact for the build folder. Next,UI build test job and Docker image build push job get the build result folder from the artifact. And then we move to the caches. You see the caches are on three jobs in the pipeline. Install UI build cache, UI build, UI unit test. Install UI build cache job creates or upgrades the cache. And the UI build job, UI unit test job use cache.How do I make a decision about which job needs a cache and which job needs artifact? Before answering the question, let me show what are differences between caches and artifacts in GitLab pipeline. The table has two columns, caches and artifacts. We compare the two items line by line. First line, initial status. Both items are defined as disabled. That means it adds them into a job.Before use them. Next line, scope. Cache has two scopes, pipeline level scope or job level. Artifact defined in job level only. The third line, create and use. Create and use a cache need to add code in a job. Well, in an artifact, only create a need. Use artifacts does not need declare. And the storage location.Local cache stored in GitLab runner. Distributed cache stored in the shared location, such as AWS S3. Artifact stored in GitLab server. The latest item, cleanup. Local cache and distributed cache need to manually delete, or you can create a shared script to frequently do it. Artifact is able to auto-delete after it meets expiration time.We go to latest topic, how to use caches and artifacts in right away. The logic flowchart can help us make selection using caches or artifacts in your project. First step, figure out files type and files folder. If the file type is build dependencies, cache is good to use. If the file type is build result, use artifact back to the cache branch. Next, make a cache scope and a cache key. Usually I use cache in job scope and the cache key is a branch name. Next question, do you have a specific runner? If yes, add a tag in the job to select a specific runner to use the cache. If not, use the distributed cache. If you go to that way, you have a run test.To make sure distributed cache can speed up your build process because there's some network traffic between the GitLab runner and the distributed cache server. It may take some time. Do not forget, clean up your cache before the cache takes too much storage space. Let's back to artifacts area. Artifacts is a fit, file types is build result. They're important parameter for artifacts, expiration time. Based on your pipeline process, you have to make a decision for the expiration time window. 1 hour, 2 hours, or 1 day or 2 days. And the next step, add the artifact to your code. It is simple. As I mentioned before, the job can automatically get the artifact from the folder with the same as defined in the artifact section in the job. All topics are completed. Today, we learned what the difference is between the caches and artifacts in GitLab pipeline, and how to make a decision use cache, and how to, based on the file type to make a decision, use cache or artifacts in the jobs. Thank you, and see you in the next video.